We have to get Donald Trump off Twitter before he gets all of us executed. On September 23, 2017, he announced war on North Korea. Presently, U.S. presidents announcing war is just the same old thing new. It's a thing they do. Both Roosevelt and Wilson broadly faltered forward and backward on whether to enter the world wars. What's more, obviously, Lincoln's bad dreams about, legitimately, bringing the U.S. down a way that was ensured to begin a civil war is the stuff of legend. Regularly, the ability to take a country to war isn't to be messed with. Our present president did it in a tweet. Presently you can contend whether that is, truth be told, an assertion of war. Some of you will punctiliously and annoyingly contend that in fact we are still at war with North Korea, yet at last what makes a difference is whether the other country sees it that way. For this situation, that other country is North Korea. What's more, they, truth be told, considered it to be an unmistakable revelation of war. At last, the general population who dispatched the bombs have last say. What's more, at last, the general population those bombs are gone for pay the last cost. Those are the general population I stress over. What's more, egotistically, I stress that me and mine strength be incorporated into that gathering. In any case, don't hesitate to supplant me and mine with you and yours in light of the fact that we're altogether fucked. We have a flimsy president. Also, the principal thing you do with insecure individuals is you take away their apparatuses for harming themselves as well as other people. Donald Trump has been abusing Twitter's principles for quite a long time. Getting out people, whole ethnic gatherings, dog whistling his savage racial oppressor construct, taking in light of a Gold Star family, 1A, U.S. judge of Mexican legacy, retweeting a gif of Hillary Clinton being assaulted, following columnists. This is not really satisfactory conduct for a consistent person, significantly less a U.S. president. Furthermore, Twitter has, legitimately though gradually, prohibited different clients for comparable conduct. So for what reason hasn't Donald Trump been commenced for his rough dangers? He consented to similar terms of administration we as a whole did when he joined. On September 25th. Twitter Prime supporter Biz Stone at long last tended to the issue in a short mildly composed piece on Medium. You can go read the entire thing in less than a moment. Be that as it may, here's the fascinating and alarming as crap part. This has for some time been inner arrangement and we'll soon refresh our open confronting principles to reflect it. It's just about a disposable line. However, it holds an imperative key to Twitter's reasoning. In short, we will move the goalposts as needs be. Twitter is refreshing their approach to expressly abstain from forbidding Trump. They've done it in the past and they'll keep on doing so. In the meantime, they will likewise reveal to you that Donald Trump is held to an indistinguishable principles from every single other client. In the wake of perusing Biz's piece on Medium, I revealed to him it sounded empty. As a matter of fact, to be totally straightforward, I disclosed to him it was 100% horse crap. His answer: changing the standards to fit the circumstance is the correct inverse of standards, and the correct importance of subjectivity. It's apprehensive. Furthermore, it's sharp. Business likewise contends that Trump's tweets are newsworthy. What's more, I don't oppose this idea. It's newsworthy to check whether a president begins a war on your stage. Indeed, it's a media upset. Take that, Facebook. Too bad, Twitter isn't a media organization. On the off chance that they were, they'd realize that the capacity of a media organization isn't to make news. The newsworthiness esteem is a daily paper media esteem. It has significance in that setting. As indicated by my companion Ross Flo 8, who, dissimilar to me, really has a news coverage degree, that importance is gotten from three esteems: significance, timeliness, and proximity. Newsworthiness isn't this as utilized to break news. Utilizing the qualities as they depict makes all despised discourse secured, on the off chance that I undermine to kill you, and after that complete, that is absolutely newsworthy. Appropriate newsworthiness isn't a something that a calculation does on the fly. It's a human esteem judgment. Additionally, the newsworthy contention isn't in their terms of administration at this moment either. As indicated by Biz Stone's Medium piece, they'll be including it soon. Once more, they're refreshing their approach to unequivocally abstain from banning Trump. I'm accepting that one of the standards Biz trusts he is alluding to is free discourse. I'm a major enthusiast of free discourse too. I tend to revile a great deal, but free discourse isn't free of repercussion. Likewise, the First Amendment, which is short and to the point, expresses that the administration can't limit your discourse. It doesn't make a difference to Twitter, which is a private administration. You know how barkeeps can chew you out of a bar for being a hostile dick? They have a privilege. You don't have the privilege to be a contentious dick in their bar. Twitter has a privilege to chew you out of their private administration for acting like a pugnacious dick as well. In any case, Donald Trump is the butthole in the corner shouting at everybody and snatching each lady's rear end and advising the barkeep not to serve the darkies. What's more, Twitter imagines that person is the reason individuals go to the bar. Twitter trusts it's ensuring free discourse, however it's truly securing the combative dick at the bar, to the detriment of alternate supporters. That is not a principled position. That is a dick move. I get that Twitter needs clients, and it needs eyeballs to survive. Furthermore, the Trump Twitter economy is solid. As per Fortune, Trump is worth about $2 billion to Twitter. So say that, Biz. Disclose to us this is a business choice. An appalling one, however, but kindly don't wrap yourself on a fundamental level. Disclose to us you bite the dust without him. Simply realize that so as to spare yourselves, you're condemning us to bite the dust with him.